Yo, what is up, everybody, and welcome back to another NBA 2K15 My Career Game. Today, we are going up against the Toronto Raptors, and it's not going to be an easy game because these Raptors are pretty stacked, man. I don't know what we fear more, their offense or their defense right now. Right now, we're not really fearing their defense because D12 is wide open underneath the paint, and Danny Tice doesn't even care about defense. It doesn't matter what kind of defense you play. Apparently, I knocked down D-minus shots. Let's be real, that was probably the worst shot I've ever taken, besides some of those F shots, and it went down. But when I give Jason Terry open shots, he doesn't make them. I mean, there's a reason why I don't like Jason Terry, and this game will pretty much prove it as, you know, another brick clanks. You know, because you guys may see Jason Terry and he makes a few shots and you're like, yo, Cookie, why are you hating on Jay Terry? Like, why are you hating the Jet? He's a veteran. He helped Dirk win his first championship. Well, he helped Dirk win his first championship a few years ago. Now, all he does is miss. And then you see Dwight miss the offensive putback, as Dwight usually doesn't do in 2K unless he's on your team. That's just the way 2K works in Hall of Fame, man. As you see, my matchup tries to take it to the rim, doesn't get it to go. Meanwhile, Dwight's 1-for-5. We're down 15. This game is looking absolutely ugly right now. Then I hit the bench. We're down 22. Make that 23 after someone decides to leave Vasquez open for 3. I bet you if Harden's on the court, it was probably Harden's guy. Maybe Terry, I don't know. And here, Terry, speaking of leaving people open, they leave Terry open, but they know what they're doing because they know Terry cannot hit. He couldn't hit a like parked car with a bowling ball, alright? Terry's not good. So we go into half. We're down a couple of points, or a lot of points, I should say, and for some reason, Doris Burke decides to interview the rookie Danny Tice. Let's see how this goes.
Well, obviously a lot of ground for you guys to make up in that second half. Do you expect Coach to shake things up to try to jumpstart you here in the third?
I wouldn't be surprised if he did. We came out late to ag that first half, straight up. Right now, any change to wake us up would be welcome. But we know we can play a lot better than that.
Hang tough, young man. Kevin, this league is not easy on the young ones.
I chose the modest approach, even though, you know, if I gotten a few more assists from Terry, we would be a lot closer. But at the same time, I'm not really pulling much weight out here. As you see, I'm pulling up a shot and actually getting it to go. Even though I did make that shot, not my numbers are crazy popping out the board or anything as Kyle Singler comes off his screen, but doesn't get it to go. And in the second half, I started running a lot of plays. That is something I never have done in 2K, was run the 2K smart plays, whatever they're called. But in this game, we were just struggling offensively. I just didn't know what else to do, so I started running these plays, and apparently that's the voodoo to get Jason Terry to actually make a shot. I swear, I'm pretty sure that was his first shot he made all game. You see, I'm sitting on the bench next to Terry. I'm like, get me away from this clown, you know? And we come into the game, and all of a sudden, it's actually kind of close. It's, you know, an 11-point game. We were down like 25 or something like that earlier. And after I make this shot, we bring it back down to 11. Looked like it wasn't going in, as most of my shots don't go in. But that one did go in, and Danny Tice, dang, like, chill, man. I don't think Danny's ever dunked the ball before, but he definitely tried to do it just now, and he tried to do it over Valanciunas, and that didn't happen. And you see, we find an open Kyle Singler for a deep two, and Singler couldn't get to go, and that's just the way this game was, man. No one really made their open shots. We didn't come out the win. We'll hopefully go into the next game where people make their shots. We'll see how that goes. But before we do that, we got a few cutscenes to go through, including this weird one.
There he is. Hey, how are things back home?
Same as they ever were.
All right.
Listen, when are you going to come over to the house and have dinner? You know, Jeannie thinks I haven't invited you yet.
All right. Listen, tell her as soon as things slow down for me. So probably in the off season, okay?
All right, sounds like a plan. Now listen, you stay focused out there. Make your old ball coach proud.
All right. Yes, sir, I will, okay?
All right.
I was in town with another one of my clients, Dante Exum, and had to see if the rumors were true. Guess they are. New digs. Look who's moving up in this world. I'm sure you already know Dante, the biggest player to come out of Australia since ever. He can run the point, move over to the two guard, whatever anybody needs. He's about to take the league by storm.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
And this is the man I was telling you about, Dante. Destined to be the biggest undrafted success in the history of the league. Ballin', making money, going places.
Maybe, but he's gonna have to go through me to get there.
Ha! Boy, you acting like that's a challenge.
Take it however you want. You see what I mean on the court.
fellas, let's keep it cordial. We're all in the same money-making family here.
Alright, so first of all, we got a few things to go over. One, what is my high school coach doing? I didn't really understand that scene too much. Nothing really happened. He just came to the game. Cool, I guess. Two, you know, I need my teammates to make shots, all right? I get we're on Hall of Fame and 2K is supposed to be cheesing the hell out of you, and Jason Terry is just trash in general, but, I mean, really, 2K, the amount of open shots your teammates miss, it's kind of, you know, you want to pull out your hair if you had a lot of hair. If you don't, then, you know, you're just going to end up throwing your remote and breaking it. But, third thing is Dante Exum decided to come to my house with my agent. All right. Did my player dude they make you control or whatever in the cutscenes? Your dude is very hostile and very cocky. That's not really the way I roll. You guys know that. I'm not one of those kind of people. Definitely, you know, far from it, I think. I don't like to think. I'm not really that kind of thing to, you know, make confrontations like that with people. As Denny Tice takes it all the way to the rim, and I believe that's his first actual dunk, and not a dunk attempt that got blown. So, you know, of course, my dude, when Dante Exum poses, like, the littlest of threats, decides, he's like, ah, you're nothing, man. I'm Denny Tice. I can't make a goddamn jump shot, but I'm a beast, you know? Like, all right. Like, you know, as proven here, brick. I'm like Jason Terry out there. But that's why I passed the ball. That's why I'm the point guard. Jason Terry's a shooting guard, all right? As you see, Dwight, I believe. Was that Dwight that flopped underneath the rim? A reigning former defensive player of the year? Like, come on, man. Dwight, what are you doing out there? Like, how are you going to flop? I expect Harden to do that, but not you. Speaking of Harden, Harden is not off to a good start in this second half right now. This game was close throughout, and here you see Denny Tice setting up for another dunk. And thanks to a kind of sort of screen by Dwight Howard, we get another dunk. And we're going to see a few replays of this because Denny's dunking out here, man. Now, your dunk rating gets upgraded with a few things. As you see, I'm coming off a screen here and not getting that shot to go near the end of the third. I didn't really want to take it, but the play was designed for me. I didn't really expect it. And at the end of the third quarter, we weren't going to get a better shot, believe it or not, even though that one wasn't too good. But, yeah, in this game, you have to upgrade, like, a few attributes at once as we make a nice cross-court pass to James Harden for the assist. So, when you're upgrading your athletic ability, your speed, your quickness, your vertical, one of the things you upgrade is your dunk, your standing dunk, and your just dunk in general, as then he gets a three to go in the fourth quarter. Hard to believe. And we're trying to get that screen going, trying to get me getting their dunk, but they actually double-teamed me this time off of that play, and I find an open Terrence Jones, but Jones doesn't get that to go. Meanwhile, Wiggins getting this to go. Not much else you can do in that situation. We had a nice little lead, but the Timberwolves made a nice little comeback here, but, yeah, so even if I didn't want to upgrade my dunk like I didn't do in previous years until like the second season last year, I didn't really have much of a choice unless I wanted my dude to be slow as hell, you know? So I had to do it. And you see Pekovic fouls out here. Pekovic had gotten 5 fouls in like the third quarter, and Harden's able to get Peck out the game. I was hoping Harden would do it because I'm not really too good at driving at the rim right now. My dude's not really much of a layup maker. And so, you know, Harden had to do it. And meanwhile, Corey Brewer is making post fadeaways over Dwight. Alright, 2K. And then Kevin Martin being called for the offensive foul. That's his fourth foul of the game. And a tie ball game gives us back the ball. But we inbound the ball to Dwight Howard. Come on, man. Come on, man. That's number one Shaq in a fool right there. Are you kidding me? And then we left Thaddeus Young open. I don't know who it was. Probably wasn't James Harden, even though Harden was late on the rotation. But either way, we goofed up. And then Kevin Martin knocks down this shot, brings the lead to 4 points. And the game where it looked like we had a shot, kind of my fault, because obviously I'm the rookie running the point here, and I'm not really getting people the ball right now, open looks, whatever it may be. But either way, you know, sucks to come out with the loss. But then we get back-to-back buckets, and we're back in this one with 34 seconds left. Harden ties the game with a nice isolation move, and here you see Thaddeus Young trying to force the ball in the paint. Kevin Martin's gonna get it, and Kevin Martin's not gonna make the shot. James Harden gets a hand in his face. Beautiful defense there, and with 10 seconds left, we have a chance to win the game. They inbound the ball to me, even though I didn't call for it. I want to give the ball to Harden here, but it's too late. I gotta run some pick and roll, trying to drive to the rim, can't do it, kicking it out to Harden for the win. Harden can't get it to go, and I'm telling you, man, I didn't want to take that shot, and that definitely affected the way I played that possession, because I wasn't really thinking of shooting. At the end, it was, you know, like, I wanted to drive to the rim, or I was gonna kick it out to Harden, and Terrence Jones didn't really set a good screen, so I ended up giving Harden like a D-plus shot, hoping he would harden the shot in, but it was a pretty hard shot, pun intended, what am I saying? Either way, we're going to overtime without Denny Tice, and the team ends up losing the game without Denny Tice. Good call, coach. Jesus Christ, I hate when that happens, man. You bring the game to overtime, you kind of screw up, you want to redeem yourself, and you can't. So either way, leave a like in the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe for more 2K15 micro games. I'm going to catch you guys next time, and I'll leave you guys with another cutscene.
Every day that you in the hood.
Just wanted to drop a little knowledge your way.
We're in an exclusive club. A lot of people think the NBA life is easy, but I know different. There are ups and downs. Pressures most people got no clue about. Want to make sure you were dealing okay.
Oh yeah, man, I'm good.
All right, because if I've learned anything, is that your work ethic and consistency is the most important thing in the NBA. As long as you're putting that work in every single day, you'll be fine.